All right. So excited to show you our new Gen 2 turbocharger. Totally different compressor wheel and cover. We're using a billet 11 blade, full 11. Changing from our 12, 6 full, 6 half. On the gas stand, this thing is super efficient. And we've got a ported compressor. And I'm happy to say that we're actually taking pre-orders on them now, and they will be available in about 1 month, which is May of 2018. So super excited, been a long time coming, and cannot wait to sell a bunch of them. Inch twin turbo LS. This what's interesting about this package is it's the daily driver. So we've been working on improving a bunch of things. And what makes this combination so special is that we'll show you here in a minute is that this truly is the daily driver series. Runs like a stock rocker and an inch 250 spring pretty much. I think it's an inch actually 300. But open spring pressure is only like 375 pounds open, which is something that you're going to be able to drive in a daily driver. I mean, you can drive it across country if you want. And what's crazy is when you hear the motor, you're going to understand just how docile this motor is. It's fucking crazy. You know, really mellow hydraulic roller cam making, you know, 1650 horsepower with a ton of power left in it. I imagine if we lean on it, it's gonna make over 1800. Another thing that we've done is we're just trying to learn all we can. We've got the new generation 2 turbos on. So these things are fucking pretty crazy. It's an 11 blade versus our 12, 6 full, 6 half. It's ported. Real high efficiency turbo, and we're trying to understand a lot of things about, you know, turbo back pressure and pressure drop in the intercooler. So we've got all sorts of temperature, you know, going into the intercooler, temperature coming out of the intercooler, pressure in, pressure out, pressure on the inlet, temperature on the inlet of the turbo, temperature on the actual exhaust gas coming out, and you know, trying to learn something, trying to be better. And these Gen 2s are definitely a sexy, I think it's like one of the best looking turbos that we've came out with to date. They even sound different with the portings. They come up, they have this crazy little whistle. But super stoked on this package. It's going in our 67 Supercar Camaro. 1,650 horsepower. Putting it mildly, that was at 28 pounds of boost, and this will definitely make 36 when we crack it. But I mean, it's just unnecessary. It's cool to talk about though.
After that, we're gonna, I'll be, so it's like, I don't have time to rebuild a window right now.
It just rattles because there's no rubber.
Turbos off. I'm going to put the generation 2 turbos on. This is really, really going to be interesting to see what the difference is between the Gen 1 turbo and the Gen 2 turbos. Oh, yeah. Moment of truth. We've instrumented the hell out of this thing. Still could be more, but for now this is going to have to do. So we've got turbine inlet pressure, turbine inlet temperature, turbo outlet temperature, we've got compressor temperature after the intercooler, before the intercooler, boost at the compressor, boost after in the intake. So I'm going to learn something here, hopefully.
Testing 447 cubic inch twin turbo LS. We've got the new generation 2 turbos on here, and this motor right here, this is a daily driver. So what's so amazing about this motor is we just ran it at 1650 horsepower. It made like 1570 foot pounds of torque, and that's not even what it's got. It's going to easily make over 1800. That was at 28 psi. I didn't even care about pushing it any more than that, just because it's going into one of our supercars. It's 1967 Camaro that we're building, which is an NRE supercar. It's going to be insane. But 1650 horsepower is enough for that car. But what's really insane is it makes 1300 horsepower on pump gas, and at 6 pounds of boost, it makes 900 horsepower. So the thing is just, I'm super impressed with it. And we're going to take this valve cover off in a second. I'm going to show you what's under the valve cover, and you're going to see what kind of spring is controlling this valve train. It's got like 375 pounds open spring pressure. You can drive this across the country and never hurt this valve train. So pretty impressive. Daily Driver series, cracking 1,650 horsepower with a lot more to spare. Boost comes on real easy, and the motor just—it's just super smooth and tame. You'll see it when it's idling. It actually idles if you want to idle it down to like 850, just high vacuum. I think this is a good motor for a lot of people that want an LS to put some miles on, but crazy power. I wanted to point out and show you guys is the actual valve spring combination, the valve train. So I'm going to pull the valve cover off here and just show you what kind of valve train we're working with. So your standard LS stuff, you got yourself, you know, pretty much a stock rocker. It's a hydraulic spring. It's got 375, 380 pounds of open spring pressure. This is something that's gonna live all day long in an engine package. So I think this is one of the most impressive parts of this whole deal is just how mellow this thing is. Again, daily driver package, but putting up hot rod numbers. I think that has a lot to do with the turbo combination and just the engine combination in general. I mean, obviously this idle is a lower than I'd want it to be, but it just shows you that the damn thing's idling at low 700 RPM. You know, pretty nuts.